Good morning. To the body of Christ, good morning, Clifton Baptist Church. We're excited to come to your home today. I open this scripture, I'm going to worship it. It's Psalms 24. The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, the world and they that dwell therein. For he hath founded upon the seas and established upon the floods. Who shall ascend into the hill of the Lord, or who shall stand in his holy place? He that hath clean hands and a pure heart, who hath not lifted up his soul unto vanity, nor sworn deceitfully. He shall receive the blessings from the Lord and righteousness from the God of his salvation. This is the generation of them that seek him, that seek thy face, O Jacob, Selah. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be lift up the everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, and lift them up the everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord of hosts. He is the King of glory. Selah. Amen. We welcome you to lift up your heads and give God praise, give God glory, and watch the King of glory coming to your homes right now. We will invite our saints to come and lead us in praise and worship. Put your hands together and tell God thank you as they come and lift up the name of the Lord. Amen.
Oh, Thank you.
Thank you, we tell God. Thank you, we tell God. Thank you, hallelujah, that we serve a big God. A God is able to do anything but fail. Hallelujah. If you have your Bibles, turn to the book of Psalms 118, the division of Psalms 118. Hallelujah, we tell God, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. For this is the day the Lord has made. We shall rejoice and be glad. And in your house, you need to rejoice and be glad. While you're driving down the street in your car, you need to rejoice and be glad. If you're in a sanctuary today, you need to rejoice and be glad. Hallelujah! That the Lord has made, we shall rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah. Psalms 118, if you have your Bibles. There are 29 verses in Psalms 118. We're not going to read all of them. I'm going to move around a little bit. But we're going to start with verse 1, and I'll tell you where to go from there. If you have your Bible, say amen. Amen. Psalms 118 verse 1 says, "Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, because his mercy endureth forever." Go down to verse 6. Verse 6 says, "The Lord is on my side. I will not fear. What can man do unto me?" Verse 8, "It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man." It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in princes. Let's go to verse 14. "The Lord is my strength and song, and has become my salvation. The voice of rejoicing and the salvation is in the tabernacle of the righteous. The right hand of the Lord doeth valiantly." The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord doeth valiantly. Verse 17, "I shall not die, but live and declare the works of the Lord." Why don't you say that again? "I shall not die, but live and declare the works of the Lord." And let's go over now to verse, let's keep on reading. Verse 18. "The Lord has chastened me sore, but he hath not given me over unto death. Open to me the gates of righteousness, and I will go into them, and I will praise the Lord. This gate of the Lord into which the righteous shall enter, I will praise thee, for thou hast heard me, and art become my salvation. The stone which the builders refused has become the headstone of the corner. This is the Lord's doings, it is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day which the Lord hath made. We will rejoice and be glad in it." This is the day which the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad. And it closes Psalms 118, verse 28, 29. "Thou art my God, I will praise thee, for thou art my God, I will exalt thee. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever." Heavenly Father, we thank you now for your word. We thank you now for Psalms 118. We thank you now, Lord, for being with us, Lord, as we step into the last 2 months of the year. God, we tell you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, Lord, for keeping us. Thank you, Lord, for being such a big God. We pray to God, Lord, as we go into your word, that you hide me behind the cross of Calvary, that you speak through your vessel of yours. I yield unto you. Have your way, Lord, none of me, but all of you. In your Son, in Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. Tell your neighbor, this is the day. This is the day which the Lord has made, and I will rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah. You gotta be glad that this is the day the Lord has made, and I will rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We tell God, thank you, thank you, thank you for recognizing that this is the day the Lord has made. And I want to know, I want you to know that I've come to declare one more time that I got this. I got this, I got this, I got this, I got this, I got this. On last week, we looked at our text, Philippians 4:13, which says, "I can do all things through Christ Jesus that strengthens me." So therefore, I can still declare that I got this. And my declaration has not changed. And not only because of that, I can also say that this is the day the Lord has made, and I will rejoice and to be glad in it, that I will give God praise, and I will tell God thank you, that I will exalt his most holy and righteous name. Last week we said, I want to recap just 3 points. One of our first points was to declare the right thing out of your mouth. We said it before that death and life is in the power of the tongue. So we have to watch what we say and watch what we allow to come out of our mouth. Our second point for last week was to do something, to take action. We said faith without works is dead. And our third point for last week was we had to know that as strength is available to us, that God gives us strength when we're weak, and God gives us strength. We say that the joy of the Lord is my strength. So I can still declare that I can do all things through Christ Jesus that strengthens me. I can declare that I got this, but that when it all boils down to it, when I take everything and I put it all together, I have to recognize that this is the day that the Lord has made, and I must give him glory. I must be glad in it. I must tell God thank you. So because of all of this, our text open up with a command. It says, oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Now, why is this important? We said last week that we have to watch what we declare out of our mouth. And sometimes what we do is we go to mute too often and too fast and for too long that we don't give God thanks. But the Bible says, oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. And he makes that bold declaration. But then in verse 2 it says, let Israel now say that his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Aaron now say that his mercy endureth forever. Let them that fear the Lord say that his mercy endureth forever. So if you're a part of Israel, or if you're a Levite, if you're a priest, if you fear the Lord, you got to recognize that his mercy endures forever. And because of his mercy, that means you should have a praise somewhere in your bosom, ready to tell God, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, in this season. Because I declare that this is the day that the Lord has made, and I will rejoice and be glad in it. Why can I rejoice and be glad in the day, regardless of what's going on? Look at verse 6. Verse 6 gives us comfort in that it says that the Lord is on my side. You can stop right there. The Lord is on my side. You don't need your big brother. You don't need your mama. You don't need your daddy. You don't need your little piece that's underneath your pillow. All you need is the Lord that is on your side. And the psalmist said, I will not fear. Why? Because the Lord is on my side. In the face of trials, in the face of uncertainty, in the face of challenges, we got to declare that the Lord is on my side. So I can declare that I got this regardless of what's going on. Regardless of what's going on with the election, regardless of what's going on with the pandemic, regardless of what's going on with social injustice, regardless of what's going on, I got this, for the Lord is on my side. When you look at me, I'm not standing by myself. When you see me walking, I'm not walking by myself. When you see me going through my trials and my tribulations, I'm not going through by myself, for the Lord is on my side. So how can I lose with God being on my side? Why should I fret? Why should I get weary? Why should I throw in the towel if God is standing right beside me? He's on my side. So when situations get heavy and I can lean on him because I know he's on my Psalms 18, 1 through 6 says, I will love thee, O Lord, my strength. It says that the Lord is my rock and my fortress and my deliverer and my God and my strength, in whom I will trust, my buckler and the horn of my salvation, my high tower. I will call upon the Lord, who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from my enemies. The Lord is on my side. Who's on your side? Your rock, your fortress, your deliverer, your God, your strength. Everything you need is standing right here. So why should you worry? Why should you fret? Why should you get upset? Verse 4 says in Psalms 18, the sorrows of death compassed me, and the floods of the ungodly men made me afraid. The sorrows of hell compassed me about. The snares of death prevented me. In my distress, I called upon the name of the Lord and cried unto God, and he heard my voice from his temple, and my cry came before him, even unto his ears. So I can call the name of the Lord who is standing by my side, and he will answer. So I can't declare, I got this, I got this, I got this, I got this, I got this. I know in spite of what's going on that the Lord is on my side. You need to highlight that, underline that, write it in your Bible, text it, go ahead and put it in your Facebook Live. Say, the Lord is on my side. You got to tell the devil every now and then, you better back up because you don't know who you're messing with. You don't know what's going on. You don't know who's standing right beside me. My big brother Jesus is standing right here. You better take a step back. He's on my side. He's on my side. Because he's on my side, I don't put my trust in man. I don't put my trust in princes. The Bible says in verse 8 of Psalms 118, it is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man. It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in princes. So you gotta ask yourself, why are you saying your brother is standing there? Your big brother Jesus is on your side. You gotta ask yourself the question, where lies your trust? All right. Some of us have, I saw a sign, I didn't want to say this because I didn't want to say his name, but I saw a billboard that said, only Trump and God can get us out of this. The devil is a lie.
That's right. Amen.
You don't need to put your hope, your trust in man. You don't need to put your hope and your trust in government. You don't need to put your hope and your trust in your bank account or your job or your employer or your mother or your father. Your hope lies in Jesus Christ, the Lord of Lords, the King of Kings. So ask yourself the question, where lies your trust? Have you placed your trust in man? Have you placed your trust in those that rule over you? Have you placed your trust in government officials that cannot get along? Have you placed your trust in the almighty dollar? Have you placed your trust in your influence and the color of your skin, your social economics? Have you placed your trust in those things that have not proven themselves to be a sure foundation? But I beg to differ that I place my trust in the Lord. Psalms 20, verse 6 through 8 says, now know I that the Lord saveth his anointed. He will hear from his holy heaven with the saving strength of his right hand. Verse 7 says, some trust in chariots and some in horses, but we will remember the name of the Lord our God. Some trust in chariots, some trust in horses, those things that seem to be very strong and very confident and able to hold up, but I put my trust in the Lord. They are brought down and fallen, but we are risen and stand upright. When you put your trust in God, you put your trust in the sure thing. Psalms 28 and 7 says, the Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart trusts in him and I am helped. Therefore, my heart greatly rejoiced, and with my song will I praise him. Psalms 34 and 8 says, oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man that trusts in him. Psalms 37 verse 3 says, trust in the Lord and do good. So shalt thou dwell in the land, and thou shalt be fed. Proverbs 3, 5, and 6 says, trust in the Lord with all thy heart, and lean not to thy own understanding, and all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. Where lies your trust?
Amen.
When you place your trust in Jesus Christ, you can stand firmly and boldly and say, I got this. When you place your trust in Jesus Christ, you can say, oh, that this is the day the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad. And when you place your trust in Jesus Christ, you don't have a problem clap of your hands, because that shows that you have confidence in God's ability to get you out the hell that you may be experiencing. I don't allow my situations to dictate my praise. I don't allow my situations to dictate where my trust lies. I don't allow my situation to dictate my response to my God. So my trust is in Him. So I recognize that He's walking right beside me. I recognize that my trust is in Him. Because I realize I can't do nothing by myself. When you recognize that you cannot do anything by yourself, you will place your trust in Jesus Christ. So because of that, I can declare that my God is my strength. I can declare that my God is my strength. Verse 14 says, the Lord is my strength and my song, and it's become my salvation. You have to know where your strength comes from. You have to know that it's not you that's why you're strong. It's not your might, it's not your ability, it's not your gifting, it's not your influence that you have what you have, but in your weakness, God is made strong. When you're able to humble yourself before the hand of a mighty God, God is able to exalt you in due time. When you recognize that if it had not been for the Lord who was on your side, you wouldn't have the things that you have. You wouldn't be able to get through the stuff that you made it through if it had not been. The Lord is my strength. Sometimes some of us have went through hell and high water, and we don't know how we made it because we wanted to quit. We wanted to crawl up in the bed and cry and don't come out the house anymore. We wanted to just give up and throw in the towel, but you've been able to stand in the face of adversary, stand in the face of your competition, stand in the face of the devil, and you don't know how you're standing, but you're still standing. Let me tell you how you're standing. It is the strength of the Lord. We're able to muster up the praise. We're able to muster up the name of Jesus. The joy of the Lord.
Regardless of your ups within a day, regardless of your downs within
contamination, regardless of the bad news that you get within a day, regardless of your naysayers, regardless of the phone calls, regardless of the disappointments and the setbacks, if you can recognize that God is on your side, if you can recognize that He is your strength, if you can recognize that all your hope, all your trust is in Him, why do you sit there with your mouth closed and not give God glory? It doesn't have to be your birthday for you to celebrate the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. This is the day, every day of the week. This is the day, every day of the week. You may want to look in my eyes. This is the day. Whether it's Monday, this is the day. Tuesday, this is the day. Wednesday, this is the day. Thursday, this is the day. Friday, this is the day. Saturday, this is the day. Sunday, this is the day. So every day you got to wake up and declare the goodness of the Lord. Every day you got to wake up in spite of the hell, in spite of the unknown, in spite of, and say, this is the day the Lord has made. I shall rejoice and be glad in it. Good God Almighty, pray you will declare. The time I wake up at 5:30, 6 o'clock in the morning, I got to say, this is the day. With cold in my eye, I probably got my full bearings again. I haven't taken my shower yet, but I'm going to declare that this is the day that the Lord has made, and I'm going to find my joy again. I'm going to rejoice and find my joy again. I'm going to give God glory. I'm going to clap my hands. I'm going to tell God thank you. I'm going to say hallelujah. I'm going to tell God thank you, Jesus. I'm going to thank you. I'm going to thank you. Because the Bible commands us to give God praise. Look now, look now, look now, look now. Let's go down to verse 27, verse 28. Verse 28. We got Psalms 118, 29 verses. Because of what's laid out in verses 1 all the way down to the end. Verse 28 says, thou art my God. Thou art my God. I recognize through everything that I've been through that you are my God. And because you are my God, not I might, not I anything, let me, but I will praise you. For thou art my God. I will exalt you. If you know what you know, what you know, if He is your God, you got to say that I'm going to praise you. I'm going to exalt you. I'm going to lift up your most holy and righteous name. I'm going to, with all the breath I have, in spite of it all, I'm going to give you glory. In spite of who wins the election, whether my candidate wins, whether it's locally or on the state level or nationally, I'm going to praise you anyhow. Regardless what goes on in the pandemic, I'm going to praise you anyhow. Regardless what's going on in my house, I'm going to praise you anyhow. Regardless what's going on with the coronavirus, I'm going to praise you anyhow. For thou art my God, and I will praise you. I will exalt you. What does that mean? What does that mean? What does that mean? That means I'm going to lift up the name of Jesus. I'm going to say, holy, holy, holy. I'm going to say, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. I'm going to say, thank you, thank you, thank you. That means I'm going to say, He is a good God. He is a mighty God. He is a strong God. He's able to do anything. I'm going to lift up His holy name. I'm going to tell Him, thank you. Thank you for getting there. In spite of it all, for I recognize I shall live and not die, but declare the works of the Lord. I recognize where my help comes from. I recognize that I have been commissioned. I have been commanded to give God glory. So this is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice. We will rejoice. We will rejoice. You got to say that in your house. You got to say that in your neighborhood. You got to say that in your church. We will rejoice. There's no questions about it. There's not a choice. You don't have a choice. When mama prays and daddy prays, you praise. When mama clap, you clap. When mama stands, you stand. When daddy say hallelujah, you say hallelujah. You fall in line with the order of the house. So we got to recognize that God is a good God. And with all of this, you can say, I got this. For I know God is on my side. And because you know God is on your side, because you know Romans 8, that talks about we are more than conquerors. I was going to read that, but you can read it yourself. Romans 8, verses 28 through 37. We're just going to go there, but we're moving on. You recognize that you are more than a conqueror. Through him that loved us, that you recognize that all things going to work together for your good. So in spite of it all, you able to say, I got this because I know God going to bring me out. And because of that, I'm going to praise God every day of my life. The devil, you won't steal my praise. The devil, you won't steal my hallelujah. I'm not putting it on layaway. I'm not putting it on pause. I'm not waiting to see what's going to happen. I'm going to praise God before I see the end result. Because I know in the end, I know that he's going to work it out for my good. My deliverance is on the way. My breakthrough is on the way. God is turning my situation around now. He's on my side. And with God, I cannot lose. I don't know who I'm talking to. You need to recognize you're not by yourself. What you experience, but good God Almighty, you can be the only one that are able to praise God through it. And as you go through it, you're able to shout hallelujah while you wait on the resolution. Hallelujah while you wait on the outcome. Hallelujah until God manifests your breakthrough. Take a remote control of your life and take it off of mute. Y'all walking around on mute. You whispering your hallelujahs. But sometimes you gotta yell your hallelujahs. You gotta shout your hallelujahs. You don't wanna tell nobody what you're praying about. You don't wanna tell God thank you in advance. But I tell God thank you in advance for working it out. I said it before. What you're going through doesn't change God's mind about you. Here's the other side of that. What you're going through should not change your mind about who your God is. If you call him your deliverer, your fortress, your rock, your deliverer, your strength, your high tower, your buckler, your battle axe, he's still that in spite of your current situation. You just got to wait on your change and watch God work it out in your favor. Our last scripture is, get back to Psalm 118. You can read Romans 8 on your own. Psalms back to Psalm 118. Look at the bookends. The first one is saying it this way. If you don't think praise is important to God, you'll miss them all. Because he opens up Psalms 118 by saying, oh, give thanks. You may say, we don't take all that. Yes, it does. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. And because his mercy endures forever. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord. Why? For he is good, because his mercy endures forever. Who in here did not need God's mercy in their life? Who in here can say that your God isn't a good God? He ain't a God that's been stretched out. Look, your mercy, the mercy of God. If it had not been for the mercy of God, you wouldn't be there. You'll be tipping out with your fans up like this. If it had not been for the mercy of God that looked past your sins, that looked past your nastiness, that looked past your backbitings, that looked past all your evil, that looked past all your sins, that looked past all your sins, and blessed you anyway, that gave you a right to the tree of life. For the Bible says, oh, praise, oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. So he starts off Psalms 118 with that. And he gives us evidence from verse 2 to verse 27. And then he gets to verse 29. And he closes it again by repeating himself. Whenever God says something more than once, he wants to make sure that you're listening. So he says it again as he closes out verse 29. He says, oh, in case you didn't hear me the first time, give thanks. I know I said it in verse 1, but maybe you were sleeping. Maybe you thought it was your goodness that got you that. Maybe you thought it was your family connection that brought you through. Maybe you thought it was your education that got you the job. Maybe you thought it was your good looks that got you your spots. Maybe you thought it was your education that opened up doors. But the Bible says, in case you didn't hear it the first time, oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, and his mercy endureth forever. So good God Almighty, I'm done. But what I want you to do, wherever you are, I want you to stand up on your feet. I want you to give your God some praise. I want you to have a fast track because you're entering into a month where we're going to celebrate the goodness of the Lord. When we say this is Thanksgiving, you got to start by making the right person. It's not about turkey. It's not about dressing. It's not about the mac and cheese. But it's about a God. Start your day saying, God, you got this. Because you got this. can handle it. I can handle it. I know you're going to see me through it. So we're going to praise God. We're going to exalt the name of the Lord. We're going to sing. We're going to lift up His most holy and righteous name. We're going into November telling God thank you. We're going into November telling God thank you. We're going into November telling the Lord thank you.
Tell God, thank you for the process.
that we can keep there. You may be able to tell God, thank you, even more. But as you're on your way to your deliverance, as you're on your way to your breakthrough, as you're on your way to your health and your affirmation and your promotion, don't miss the opportunity to tell God, thank you. Says if you don't praise me, the waters will cry out. If you don't praise me, my creation will praise me. But I don't want no rock to cry out for me. I want to be able to look at where God has brought me from and be able to tell God, thank you. And he never left me. That he never forsaken me. Never seen the righteous forsaken or seen begging for bread. Even on my worst days, God allowed me to survive my worst day. And for that, you can tell God, it could have been the worst day on the calendar. But you're still here. You're still here. There's still breath. Your life. The Bible says that everything that has, the Lord. So your situation may not be the best right now, but you got to recognize that God made the day. If you are above ground, there is hope for you. And God just wants to command us to give him the glory, give him the praise, for he is good and his mercy is everlasting. I don't know where you are watching, but I find out I plead the blood of Jesus over your life. I plead the blood of Jesus over your life. I speak as a man of God into your house. God bless you. And go in peace. But this is the day that the Lord has made. And I challenge you to rejoice and be glad in it. God bless you. Hallelujah. Amen.
Thank you.